Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and welcome back to my NBA 2K14 Next Gen My GM series featuring the Minnesota Timberwolves. We are 10-8 and we are about to take on a very tough road task here, taking on the Oklahoma City Thunder. But before we do that, we're looking at the front office here and making maybe some moves here with our lineup. We've got a few players who are struggling a little bit because they're either uneasy about their role or they're just flat out mad they're not getting playing time. Those two players in particular are Alexi Shved and, more importantly and more drastically, Corey Brewer. Brewer not finding a whole lot of time because of Chase Buttinger in the starting lineup there. So, yeah, he's dropped down to a 66 overall dynamically here. He's normally mid-70s. We're going to go see if there's any possibility if we could package these two players and what we could get for them and maybe get some new life into this lineup here. I mean, you know, I feel bad for Corey Brewer. He's a great player, especially on the defensive side, and I'd like him to be happy here. So I actually find a deal that's fairly even, but I find some players who are actually younger than what we would be giving up. And we're going to give a call over to Cleveland and see if they might want to work this deal for Corey Brewer and Alexi Shved going out, and it would be Alonzo G and Tristan Thompson coming our way, and it looks like they're going to go for that. So I kind of like that. We get a little bit younger. We're going to help ourselves out at the power forward position there as a backup. So now we've got to adjust the lineup now that we made the trade. Time to talk to the assistant GM here in my office, and we're going to go ahead and go through and look at the rotation, maybe even rebuild it a little bit since we have a couple new parts to fit in there. So we figure that Alonzo G will probably be a starter at his position. Now, that's not how it sets up right here right now, but we do look, and he is rated higher than Chase Buttinger. Buttinger's a 69. When we get down to Alonzo G, eventually, there he is. He is a 72 overall. So I think we're going to go ahead and insert him in the starting lineup. Now, Chase Buttinger might not be real happy about that, but we can still work him in the rotation. And now you see when we get down here, Tristan Thompson's a 75 overall, which is very nice there. But obviously, he's not going to start over Kevin Love, who's an 87. And an NBA star. So he is basically going to be our sixth man. And I'm going to try to work him in at a lot of minutes to keep him happy. So hopefully that'll work for him. And we'll just have to see how this goes with our new rotation. So now we are ready to go take on the Thunder. Now they're 12-2 and they've won 8 of their last 10 ball games. As a matter of fact, look at this tough schedule coming up. The Thunder, the Spurs, the Heat. Even the Pistons are doing well. Then we get a break with the Sixers. But after that, I think we play the Spurs again. It is a tough stretch for the Timberwolves if they want to stay above 500 and in the race here early on. So this is where it all starts. A very tough road game against the Oklahoma City Thunder and Kevin Durant. He will obviously be the main man to stop, but you got to worry about Russell Westbrook, obviously, as well. So we'll see how well we do on the defensive end here stopping these offensive powers here. But, you know, they play some D as well. They play a pretty good all-around game here in Oklahoma City. So there is a reason why they are 12-2. Losing the handle there is Pekovic, but he gets it over to Rubio. Kicks out to Love, and he's going to miss that. Nice rebound right there by Pekovic, but it will not go. Having some problems on the offensive end early. Russell Westbrook isn't, though. He makes it 6-1 on that shot early. And let's see here. You got Alonzo G kicking it down to Pekovic. Back out. And Alonzo G hits the three. Welcome to this Minnesota Timberwolves lineup right there. But they've got some work to do. Falling behind early. The alley-oop goes right there. And the Timberwolves are all messed up here defensively, as Oklahoma City is taking it to them. 15-5. Roten in the game. He's going to miss from three. And we get a silly foul there by Tristan Thompson in frustration. Now 16-5, but the Thunder keep coming. They get another basket there. They've stretched this early lead to 18-5. The Wolves need to cut into this, and they need to do it quick. Barea finds Roten driving, and that's a nice job filling the lane and getting the basket. As the first quarter winds down, let's cut into it even a little bit more, shall we? That is a pass to J.J. Barea underneath, and at least they cut it to 18-9. Wow, okay. Into the second quarter, kicking it out to Kevin Martin, and maybe, just maybe, we can make a run and get back in this before it gets way out of hand. 18-12 now with that three-pointer. Martin, once again, this time he's going to feed to Pekovic, who goes left-handed and gets it to go. It's now 18-14. Minnesota coming back. As Westbrook looking to dribble behind his back, but that doesn't work out. They pick it off. Rubio to Alonzo G, who stuffs it home. It's now 18-16. Good run for the Wolves. Let's watch the replay here as he's able to get behind Kevin Durant there, actually, and stuff it home. So Alonzo G is doing his part here. Kevin Love needs to start stepping it up here. He's going to get it to Pekovic. Pack will spin around and get that one to go. Keeps it a two-point ball game. Minnesota now very much in the game despite their terrible start. That is a three ball that will go, and Oklahoma City gets their offense back on track with Jeremy Lamb there. Here is Pekovic. He's obviously not going to shoot from out there. Rubio kicks it to Love quickly, who hits from three and ties the ball game. They've come all the way back now before halftime. Oklahoma City with the two-point lead. Westbrook stops and pops that one. Make it four-point lead right there as he hits. Derek Fisher in the game now. Going to find Jones underneath. That's a basket. Oklahoma City stretching it out a little bit again before halftime here. Nine-point lead going into half as Rubio chucks up a prayer. And oh, he gets it to go. Three-pointer, which is very much a bonus there. Just throwing it almost half court, and it will fall for a three-pointer, and it cuts it to a six-point lead at half. So all in all, it could have been much worse after the start they endured here. Rubio to Love. We've seen a theme starting here. Love heating up from three as Rubio feeds him once again. Down seven right now. Let's do it again, shall we? Kevin Love, he makes another one. And it's 40-36. Timeout right there for the Thunder. Maybe they want to fix their perimeter defense right there. What's working here is the mid-range shot for Kevin Durant. He's going to go ahead and hit that. He is always a rock and a consistent shooter right there. As you see Kevin Love consistently hitting those threes. He hits another. He's got nine second half points, and Rubio gets a steal. He is going to get the fast break score. No problem there. And once again, it's a one-point ball game. Midway through the third quarter, Westbrook looking to do some work. Loses the handle. Rubio picks it up. Let's run the floor. We've got some options here. Rubio over to Kevin Martin, who puts it home. The Timberwolves have the lead at 45-44. This game very much back and forth now. Jeremy Lamb finds Westbrook wide open underneath, and Oklahoma City stretches to a three-point lead. Let's make it more. Jeremy Lamb hits from three. Just like that, they're up six. Third quarter almost over, 53-45. Wolves need to be careful here. They need a bucket. Is it going to be Kevin Love for three again? Of course it is. He hits another three. What a quarter for Kevin Love. Budinger down low to Kevin. What can he do here? That is a no, it won't go, actually. He was shooting hot, but Tristan Thompson is there to get the rebound and put it back. So another one of our new additions is helping out down low. Kevin Martin gets a bucket there, and it's 53-52. We've come back to make it a one-point game again. Jackson underneath to Jones. No, it won't go. Budinger the rebound. Here we go. Tristan Thompson to Rubio. He's going to kick it back to Kevin Love for another three-pointer, and it is good. 55-53, Minnesota. The outside shooting keeping him very much in this game. Kevin Love working down low this time, and we'll get a bucket. A four-point lead. That's got to be their biggest lead of the game, but Westbrook will not be denied. Look at him move. Look at him make cut to the basket there and tie the game at 57. We're coming down the stretch in a very close one. You got Durant is posting up on Alonzo G. He gave him a little bit too much room there because then he's going to say, I'll take that. Thank you very much. 59-57. We got a 61-59 game now. Lamb underneath, and that is Collison's going to put it home. Four-point lead for Oklahoma City. The crowd is loving that. Kevin Love trying to get a bucket here. That's not going to go. It's off the front iron. Rebounded, and that will lead to a series of free throws. The Thunder hold on and win 66-59. Good effort, but I think that had they not started so sluggishly, it would have been a much different deal. So it's back home to take on the San Antonio Spurs. Things do not get much easier, do they? We are playing some very quality opponents in this early stretch of the season, but hopefully the Target Center crowd will get behind us here and maybe we can find a way to down the Spurs on this night. So we're getting ready. Tim Duncan's getting ready for this road game. He's all set here as he kind of takes everything in. So here we start. Kevin Martin, down low to Pekovic. You want to start that low block presence if we can right away, and we do. We get the first 2 points of the game here. How about Kevin Martin from three? Yes, sir. Dial it up, and it's 5-0 out of the blocks. Here comes San Antonio back with the next two baskets. But Kevin Love, the up and under, and it's good. And he's fouled by Tim Duncan. Nice play right here by K-Love. Let's see him go up and under, like I said, off the glass and in. And he gets the contact. So it's 12-9 Minnesota. Trying to play some defense right here, but Kawhi Leonard instead gets a bucket underneath. We'll make it a 12-11 ball game early. It's now 13-12 San Antonio, trying to get this down to Ayers, who, wow, the left-handed hook right there. That's a beauty of a shot. Makes it 15-12 San Antonio. Roten here looking for some room. Kicks out to J.J. Barea, and he hits as the backups are in and contributing, tying the game. It's now 17-15 Barea. Looking at how to attack this defense. Again, good perimeter passing, and Barea again will hit a three. That's 6 quick points for him as Minnesota is hanging right with the Spurs. Nice pass to Alonzo G, who finishes that off and gives the Wolves the lead, 23-22. Let's play some defense. Tim Duncan. Oh, of course he's going to hit that, right? That's his range. He's feeling it right there. Puts San Antonio back in the lead. Be a lot of lead changes in this game. There is an pickoff there by Johnson to Rubio to Martin, who lays it in. Like I said, a lot of lead changes in this game. That will be a theme the entire night. Tim Duncan gives San Antonio the lead back. 26-25. We hit halftime and it's 30-28 Spurs, as it is a very closely contested game. Kevin Martin thinking about shooting that, gets a little closer, banks that in. Nice shot right there to tie the ball game. So Rubio trying to do some work on Tony Parker. Instead, this gets kicked out to Manu Ginobili, who hits the three. Yep, that's his specialty right there. Parker loses the handle. Here comes Ricky Rubio all alone down court. The fast break score, and Minnesota once again within 1 point. Let's make it a three-point game right now. Rubio looking for Kevin Love. He hits it, and they say it was a three. Boy, it was close. I guess he stepped back. Nice shot right there. Alonzo G passes up his shot. Look at the nice passing on the perimeter once again. And it's a Chase Buttinger three. Got San Antonio in the lead by 4 here. Third quarter almost over. You see Shabazz Muhammad will find Kevin Love down low for the bucket. And it's a 2-point game going into the fourth quarter, where we need to try to make a difference here tonight. Ricky Rubio from 3. That is good. Wolves in the lead by 1. All right, Ricky's fired up. And Kevin Martin gets a steal. Nice play right there. Tristan Thompson will get it back to Martin, who started the whole thing. And he slams it home, puts Minnesota in the lead again. Again, more lead changes. It's just back and forth this entire game. That's Tim Duncan down low. He's fired up. Look at that. They've got the lead back. Alonzo G. Oh, it goes in and out. But there is his Cleveland teammate, Tristan Thompson, cleaning up the garbage and putting it home. He also gets fouled on the play. Talk about fired up right there, helping out his new team right there with a rebound and a bucket, and he makes it a three-point play. So both Cleveland transplants doing well here with the Wolves so far, although you see Splitter down low abusing Pekovic and ties this game up. So now Kevin Love trying to drive. Nope, that's not going to be there. Gets it to Pekovic. Out to Ricky Rubio. He's feeling it from three in this fourth quarter. He's hit two of them now, putting Minnesota up by 3. It's a two-point game now. Tony Parker, he hesitates, but then he pops that mid-range shot, tying the game with just under a minute left. 61-59 now into Pekovic. We need the big man to score right here. Nice move right there, and he gets the bucket. We are going to go to overtime, tied at 61. Here we go now, as we need to try to get an early jump. Oh, look at that pass from Rubio to Kevin Love, and he hits. The three-pointer puts us up 3. And that's a great way to start the overtime. Ginobili trying to drive. He'll kick back out to Parker. Back to Ginobili. Parker should have shot that because Ginobili gets blocked by Love. Here we go with Rubio. Going to kick it out to Martin. who gets this back out to Alonzo G. Slow it down a little bit. Martin over to Rubio. To Pekovic. He's way outside of his range. Get that back to Rubio, who's been feeling it in the fourth. He feels it in overtime, too. Another three. 67-61. The perimeter shooting is doing in the Spurs right now here as far as the Timberwolves offense is going. But Parker's not going to worry there. He hits that. They're down one. So Minnesota trying to get the lead back up to three. Pekovic cannot get it to go, but he will get fouled. So the first is good. Ooh, that was close. But it does go down. It's a 68-66 game now. Let's see if he can hit two. No, he can't. Okay, we got a two-point game and Duncan's rebound. Here we come down the court with Ginobili. What's he got? Oh, it's picked off by Kevin Love. That's a great defensive play. Headmans to G, to Kevin Martin. And it's good, and it's now a four-point lead. That was a huge series of events right there. Tony Parker finding Ginobili. He cannot hit the shot. And the rebound goes to Alonzo G. They will follow him. Timberwolves make some free throws down the stretch and win the game 74-69 in overtime.
Well, Kevin, in a game like tonight, what sort of elements of your identity and confidence are confirmed by getting this type of win?
That we can fight through and beat any team in the league if we're playing well. So for us to get this win here, our sixth man is our crowd. They've been great. They packed the house tonight, and we got a big win against a team that's, you know, right up there with the top teams in the league.
The crowd enjoyed it, and we did too. Kevin, thanks for your time. Guys, back to you.
All right, Doris, thank you.
Well, there you go. They lost the game out in Oklahoma City, but they rebound with a very nice win against the Spurs at home. Up next will be LeBron James and the Miami Heat. They're 9-1 in their last 10 and 13-5 overall. And after that, we get the 12-7 Detroit Pistons, followed by a subpar 76ers team. And then we go away to play the Spurs once again. It is a tough stretch, but we're going to keep on going in Minnesota Timberwolves My GM mode. We'll see you next time, guys.